In 1974, the world of horror cinema was changed forever with the arrival of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, an instant classic that helped to usher in an entire era of slashers and introduced audiences to the terrifying Leatherface. Tobe Hooper's iconic horror film starred the late Gunnar Hansen as the hulking relentless villain who terrorized a group of teens after they stumbled into his remote farmhouse. Leatherface was without a doubt one of the most terrifying fictional creations the world had ever seen at the time. A ruthless chainsaw-wielding cannibal who wore a mask made of human skin. Now, fans of the franchise are in for a fresh new vision of the story when Texas Chainsaw Massacre arrives on Netflix on Friday, February 18th. Before the film debuts, let's dig into where this exciting new installment fits into the timeline of the Texas Chainsaw Massacre movies. Over the decades that followed the original 1974 film's game-changing premiere, there have been several sequels and reboots that have taken the iconic Leatherface into new directions. These range from Tobe Hooper's darkly comedic 80s follow-up, to the searing reimagination from the mid-aughts, to the prequel films that dared to dig into Leatherface's gruesome origins. The follow-up films jumped around to drastically different times and places, sometimes directly connecting to the original, but not always. However, audiences will only need to know what happened in the 1974 original to tune in for Texas Chainsaw Massacre, because the new movie serves as a direct sequel to the events of the first film, although it does take place many, many years later. The original film is relatively straightforward. A group of teens road tripping across Texas accidentally run into Leatherface and his violent cannibalistic family. After a desperate fight for survival, only Sally Hardesty survives. The original film took place shortly before the picture's real-life theatrical debut date, setting it in the early 70s. 2022's Texas Chainsaw Massacre follows that trend. It's set in the present day, nearly 50 years after all of those brutal slayings commenced in 1974's The Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The modern film introduces a new group of young travelers who set out for the virtually abandoned town of Harlow, Texas, in hopes of pursuing a bold entrepreneurial adventure. Unfortunately, their dream quickly turns into a nightmare when they discover that this town is not quite empty just yet. They accidentally stumble across the place where Leatherface has been hiding out for decades and unknowingly unleash a second wave of his rage. The 2022 Texas Chainsaw Massacre, which is directed by David Blue Garcia, will skip over all the sequels and feature the formal return of Leatherface, this time portrayed by Mark Burnham. After decades of hiding, he's become something of a forgotten folk legend, but some things should not be forgotten. Leatherface spends his days in a rundown orphanage in the care of an elderly woman, whom a photo suggests he's been with since 1975, after the events of the first film. But he still keeps his chainsaw tucked away for a rainy day. This sequel is produced by Fede Alvarez, who previously directed horror hits Evil Dead and Don't Breathe. Alvarez explains some of the creative decisions behind bringing back this hallmark of horror in his golden years in an interview with Bloody Disgusting, describing how Texas Chainsaw Massacre recaptures the feel of the very first film. As he explained, it is a direct sequel, and it is the same character. Everything is classic old-school gags, a lot of the approach we had with Evil Dead. Never do VFX, to do everything on camera. It's a very old-school approach to filmmaking, vintage lenses. It's very similar to the original film. Leatherface isn't the only survivor of the first film that fans can expect to see in the Texas Chainsaw Massacre either. Sally Hardesty is also coming back with a vengeance. Sally was originally portrayed by the late great Marilyn Burns, whose ear-shattering screams gave audiences nightmares for years to follow. This time, actress Alwyn Fowery steps into her shoes to seek some cold revenge against the monster who murdered her brother and her friends so long ago. So prepare for a lot of nostalgia and some cutting new twists when the Texas Chainsaw Massacre slices its way onto your Netflix queue on Friday, February 18th. Thanks for watching. Click the links in our video to watch more from Netflix Film Club. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.